Hey guys, what's up? In this video, I'll be teaching you everything I know about Contact Form 7. Let me show you what we are going to learn in this video. I'll show you how you can create a contact form, how to modify it and use all the fields that are available. I'm also going to show you how you can save your entries that being submitted to your website using Flamingo, how to set up a mail notification for yourself and your visitors. I'm also going to show you how you can stop spam using reCAPTCHA version 3. We're logging into our WordPress dashboard. If you're still logging in using WP Admin,
no!
Nope!
No!
That's not a very safe way, so if you don't want to get hacked, watch my tutorial about WordPress security and it will save you a lot of pain. When you're logged in, we go to Plugins, Add New. Now we're going to look for Contact Form 7. When you have found it, we press Install Now. And after that, we press Activate. You will see on the left side, you have a new item called Contact. Let's click on this one. Here you can see your first contact form. Now, if you want to place this contact form on your website, just go to your page. And within Gutenberg, you can press on this plus icon. And you can just add a contact form or type contact form like this. You can edit. Select the right form. And here we go. Now we have the contact form on our page. But if you're using Divi or Elementor, you can also use this shortcut. Click on it, right click and press copy. And on your website you have created, you can just go and add in another code module, for example, or a text module. I'm using Divi in this example. And we're going to paste in a shortcut and press save. And now we have our form inside our Divi website. So let's start creating our contact form. If you hover over this one, you can press edit. Now this is the contact form edit page. It doesn't work as nice as, for example, Grafty Forms, which I use on all my website, but Contact Form 7 is actually free. So that's why it works like this. We are going to create our entire own form. So what do? You select everything over there and we just press delete. The first thing I want to know from my visitors is their name. So click on this text button over there. If you want to make this required, just check this box. The name, you can leave it like this, is only for internal use. The default value is what people will see filled in the field when they don't click on it. We're not gonna use this one. When we have this, just press insert tag over there. And now you have this text, text. What we need actually is a label around it. So what do we type in? A label like this. I don't actually know why they don't have a button over here which says label. Well, we just work with this. And after the label, we type something like your name. And then we have the text field. And after that, we type in this slash label. Let's see how it looks on the front end. And now we see that the contact form is actually this, your name. But what if you want this line to be on the next row? If we go over here and we press enter and then we save it, now the field is below your name. So the next thing we want to know from our visitors is of course their email. Label again, your email address. And then we press enter and we press on this button, email. And it should be a required field. We press insert tag. And then we're going to close this label like this. All right, great. Save it. Now when we refresh this page, you will see your name and your email address. And maybe you want also something else to select. For example, their telephone number. Well, what do? We're just going to, for the speed, just copy this thing. And we're going to say your phone number. And we're just going to select this. And then you press on tell over here. Here we go. And let's not make it required, just press insert tag. Oh, we have to delete this one. So here we go. And now you see also a phone number field. Very easy. And for that final thing, we of course have a text area. So you're gonna need a text area and we're gonna be required insert it. And then the label should actually be, added over here, your question, like this. And just don't forget to close the label. And then we have a form like this. But there's one thing we're missing, and that is, of course, the submit button. So we go over here and we click on submit like this. The label should be submit and just press insert tag. There we go. Now we have our simple contact form created by ourselves. really easy. Now, before we start creating our emails that we send out and send to us, let's add some more fields. We're going to add over here a new label which says your website, and just press on this URL button. Here we go, it's not required, insert it and close the label. Now you can also add a website URL in here. But what if you also want a drop-down menu? No problem, Contact Form 7 has you covered. Just go over there, press drop-down menu, and here you can add one options per line. So, yes I did, no, of course you deserve it. And we press insert tag. And then we're gonna add a label. And don't forget to close your label. And now we also have a drop-down menu. Did you already subscribe and hit that like button? Yes, no, of course, you deserve it. What else you can do? You can also create checkboxes. You press on checkboxes, and the options would be Divi, Elementor, Oxygen, Beaver Builder, and we press insert tag. And the label would be something like most. And then we also have this really funny checkboxes thing. Really great. But there is even more. You can also add radio buttons over there. Options would be, I love it. You can also add emoticons in your, like this, and then press insert tag. You now see, we need a label, of course, a label. The label would be, how do you like Contact Form 7? A bit, I like it, I love it. It works. And before people click that submit button, I also want them to accept my privacy terms. So I want it over here. So I'm just going to make some space and I press on acceptance right there. And the condition is, I accept all your terms to spam me every single day for the rest of my life. But you need to uncheck this one or else they can submit the form without accepting the terms. Press insert tag over there, and then we press save. And now they have to accept it. If you don't, you can't submit the form, as you can see. But if you accept it, you can submit it. Works like a charm. The only thing I want is I accept all your terms. I want this to be clickable to another page. It's very easy. And where you want to have a link, you just type in a little HTML. So type in href is, and then you type in maybe a privacy policy, for example. Don't forget to close it like this. And then you have your terms, and then we close the entire tag. And now we can see that we have created a link inside of our form, which goes to our privacy policy page. So that's the way you can create a simple acceptance button. I also want them to upload a file to my website. Of your biggest, of course, we're gonna add an emoticon. And then we press on this one, file over there. Then we have a file size limit, except file types. Let's use .jpg, .png, and also a GIF, like this. Press insert tag, and don't forget to close the label again. And now we can also upload a picture of your biggest YouTube star over there. I totally forgot to add the date in here. On which date you want to contact me. And with this range, you can actually select from which day to which day they can put in a date inside of your form. So let's say I want this from 26 January till 24 February, insert a tag. And now you can actually select a date, but only between too early, as you can see, between this one and. And now when you go later than the date we have selected, you cannot select anything of that. So now you know the basics of how to create a form. It's really easy. You can go as nuts as you want. Let's configure the mails that are being sent out from our website. Click on mail over here. All right, let's first set up this email. As you can see, 2 is a site admin email. I would suggest you use just your email address from you, or else all admins will receive these mails. So let's say I'm going to send it to my own email, d@wpressdoctor.com. Make sure the email address is exactly the same as your domain name. So in this case, this one would be, for example, contact or info. That's okay. Site title, I would use something that you can immediately recognize when you're opening up your email. Something like from website. And the subject would be new filled in contact form. If you receive email, you are tend to just hit that reply button and send the mail back. However, it will be sent to this mail, but there is no mail there. So we go to our form, then we go to our email label, and this is the thing we need to have. So we press copy over there, we go to mail, and then we from reply to, and then we paste in over there like this, email 513. And now the error message has been removed because it now works. As you can see now, we do have an error that is because of our drop-down menus. So what you can actually do is remove this label over here and put it down there. Also with this one, remove it and put it over there. And also with this one. So drop-downs and all these things. And now you see that the error message has been removed. But everything still works as it should. Let's go back to mail. If you need to create it, we have to use the right email tags created in our form over there. But there, we can of course copy and paste everything from here, but it's not necessary. If you go to mail and we just scroll down a bit, what you can do is in the message body, just remove this entire message body because it's completely not what we've created. What we're gonna type here is this one, received from, and then we have our text over there. So we're just gonna drag and drop it over there. And then we're gonna have the email address. We already used it, so we're gonna copy it in there. And then we want the phone number. So we're gonna have it over there, the date. You can just click on this one and just drag and drop them to anywhere you want in your email, like this. Over there, and the acceptance, of course. And of course, the file has been uploaded. Oh. So this is the basis email. Then we have, if you want to use HTML, just click on this, but we don't need it for this email. And then we're gonna press save. Now this mail will be sent out to ourselves. We also like to send an email confirmation to the visitor on our website. To do that, you just go here and click on use mail number two. Like this, drop down a bit. Where do we need to send it to? We need to send it to, remove this, click on it, drag it over there. From, this would be your own company name. Like in my case, the WPress Doctor. And it's from the at WPressDoc.com. Use your domain you're using right now on your website or else it will be caught in spam. Then the subject should be, thank you so much for contacting us. And the additional headers will be reply to the at wpressdoctor.com, my official website. Or maybe you wanted to reply to something like contact or whatever you want, just fill it in over there. And then we have your message body. It could contain everything they've sent to you. If you want that, just copy this entire thing, copy, and paste it over there. And then we're gonna make it a nice header. So, dear, and then this was their name. Thank you. During this tutorial, here is everything you have sent to me. And then we press save. The next thing to do is go to messages over there. If someone submits your form, this is what they see. Thank you for your message. It has been sent. You can change that right now to rock on. Thank you so much. When it has been failed, this is what people see. When there are validation errors, one more fields have an error. I would like to change that to, please check this field. It seems that something has gone wrong. And then you can change all these tags to whatever you want to have. If you want to have some additional settings, like only make this form available for subscribers, you can add them all in there and then it will be used inside of your contact form. All right, so let's test it out. And we press submit. Rock on, thank you so much. The first mail I receive is from my website, which says email received from, and here is all the data. What you don't see is actually some text explaining what the question was. I think that it's very logical to see, so you have to add it in the mail section of contact forms. And this is the email I receive from the website as a customer, which says, "Dear," and then the name I added, "Thank you for contacting us. Here's everything you've sent me. Blah, 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 blah. I will see you very soon. Greetings." And you can create as many forms as you want with Contact Form 7. Two more things we need to have before this thing can actually go live on your website. The first thing is Flamingo. Put it in over there, Flamingo. And then you can press install now. What this does is actually stores your entries of your forms. Very useful, because when you lose all your email, you don't see anything restored. We press activate. And now when you go on the left side to Flamingo, you can see inbound messages. In here, you will find all the messages that has been submitted through your forms. When you have sent in messages, this is what you see: your subject, your name, and the channel. Well, there is a way to change this. Just go to your contact form and go to additional settings over there. Just paste in the codes you can find in the description of this video, and here we can define those columns in the Flamingo inbound messages. Here you can see your subject and the from name. These fields can be populated with whatever you want. It can be, for example, the mail tags, as we have created here, all the tags. You can also just use normal text or a combination of multiple fields. So for the subject, what I want to have is on the contact page. The email field should be this one. And then the name is this one. We paste it over here. And then we have everything, just save it. And when I now fill out my contact form, all the inbound messages, the subject is on the contact page. Another test, and the channel, it all works. And when I click on it, you can see everything that has been filled in to your form. Now another thing we actually need on our website is reCAPTCHA to get the spam bots away from our website. You go to contact and you go to integrations over there. In integrations, you can scroll down, you can find AkiSmet, which actually works really great, and we can find reCAPTCHA. Just press on setup integration, and then we need to click on this, open this in a new tab, and then we click on this link over here, and we are at the Google reCAPTCHA service. You can click on V3 admin console. You might need to register yourself first, but just add in your credentials of Google and then you can log in. And the first thing you then see is this, register a new site. We're gonna add wpressdoc.com over there. I want a reCAPTCHA version 3, or maybe you want a version 2, which you can actually have to click on I'm not a robot or a badge or whatever. We're gonna use version 3. The domain should be the exact domain name. So wpressdoc.com. Don't use HTTPS or anything, just like this. Accept the terms and services. And then we press submit. What we now have is a site key and a secret key. Copy the site key, click on it. Then we go back to contact form integrations and we're gonna paste it in over there, also with a secret key, and press paste and press save changes. It has been saved. Well done. And that's it. Now your form is protected with reCAPTCHA version 3. So when you refresh your contact page, you will see down here, you will see this button protected by reCAPTCHA. So now you know how to create a real simple contact form. If you have any questions, drop them down in the comments and I will be glad to answer them. Hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more videos about WordPress. As always, I wish you a awesome day. And if you want more complicated forms, then check out this tutorial about Gravity Forms. Because in my opinion, it works way better, but it's not free.